an egregious flaw in our economy, where there is such, you know, there's like 900 times as much pay for corporate CEOs as minimum wage workers, and to really protest the egregious inequality in our society. And I wanted to speak out on that. As I indicated earlier, you know, I put on my best suit and had my hair done, my nails done, and used the King's English to debate this in Congress, and no one is listening. And so I'm taking the advice and leadership of colleagues like John Lewis, who said, you really do have to put yourself in the way. You have to put your body in the way, your freedom in the way, your comfort in the way, in order to articulate this. It's an extremely important issue. I think it is a shame to have people working every single day and not be able to meet their basic needs. I'm not talking about anything, you know, extravagant, trip to the Caribbean, but not be able to pay their rent, not be able to have a decent car that works, not to be able to provide their kids with shoes on the first day of school, and they're working every day. People still needing food stamps and Medicaid, and yet they're working every single day.
Sure. Talk for a moment, if you would, Congressman, about the fact that you kind of shut down business, though. There are a lot of hardworking people who were inconvenienced by what happened today. Can you talk about why you felt it was important to take this kind of an action?
I think it was important to draw people's attention to low-wage workers.
That's right.
Think low-wage workers are invisible.
That's right. And that's why I
brought myself out here. I know that I am a well-known person, and I think that unless some of us are in solidarity with low-wage workers, they're invisible. They're just the people who wipe the table down for you at the fast food restaurants, and you can just sort of ignore their plight. And so I wanted to make sure that I elevated this issue so that we could get people thinking about the importance. Because we're all brothers and sisters. We're all responsible for this economy.
Right.
I promise you, every single low-wage worker, I promise you, they will patronize these businesses once they have more money. They'll be right at Best Buy, right at Pick and Save, right at Payless Shoes, right at Macy's, supporting these very businesses that we inconvenienced. If they had the resources to do it.
Talk for a minute about the nitty-gritty. Some people who agree with you say $15 is over the top. Do you think that you can make $15 happen? I mean, what about 10? What about
Well, 8? You know, the thing is, if you look at economic charts over the last 30 years, you can see that workers have worked harder and harder and harder. And while we have seen profits and stock rise tremendously, it has not kept pace with wages. And so what we see is a tremendous inequality based on an unfairness, that gap between what people at the top make and what low-wage workers make. Low-wage workers are not sharing in the tremendous profits. These companies that run fast foods are making huge dividends, and they're not sharing it with workers.
Talk for a moment, if you would, about what you expect to happen next in terms of Congress and your role in trying to change the world.
Well, this is what democracy looks like. This is why we live in the United States and not some banana republic. We live in a place where people...
We've got to be able to let people walk through here.
Okay.
And I know that you need to talk to the news, but please, if you would accommodate by allowing people to walk through the sidewalk,
we're going
to really
take
nice.
A walk. Thank you, officer.
So I think that this is what democracy is about. This is why we're happy to be citizens of the United States instead of some banana republic, because we have the right to articulate our issues and concerns, and to educate the general public, and that's the kind of pressure that brings about change. We've seen it work here in the United States. Democracy may not be comfortable or convenient for everyone, but this is the way it works.
So you were the last one off the bus, looks like.
There's one other woman who was being processed.
So what was going on in there?
We were singing, and we had a great deal of solidarity. We talked about the issues. I met all the women, and we talked about our lives, and we sang and chanted and just enjoyed each other's company.
And did you, was it just women on that particular?
Well, they isolated the women, but we did have two men through a see-through cage, so we had solidarity with them, and really just appreciated what we were doing, just really taking direct action, instead of just talking about it and grieving over it, to actually let the public know that that we're proud to be workers, we're proud, and we just want people we work for to take pride in us as well, and to pay people what they're worth.
Did you feel you were treated fairly today, professionally by the police?
I certainly felt that I was treated with dignity and with respect. You can see my arm is a little banged up, and so they accommodated that. And I was very, very happy with the way the police handled it. You know, I don't blame the police at all. I don't have any disdain or contempt for the police. You know, what I have said before is that often, we ask police to pick up the pieces from social breakdown. What we have is a complete social breakdown when a CEO can make 900 times more than a minimum wage worker. So the police were just simply doing their job to open up the street. So I don't have any beef or grievance with the police. And I felt that I was treated.
Don't touch me. Excuse me.
And who is it that invited you? Did someone invite you and ask you to be part of this?
I am involved with the workers' movement. And I learned that this was going to be happening, and I wanted to be a part of it.
All right. Well, you look warm and tired, and I look such a great.
Thank you so much. I got some hot soup at home waiting on me.
Regarding the comments that W. Washington Salt made recently about abused women, do you have a problem with those comments?
That's
by
not why we're here, sir. That's not why we're here, sir.
Can we get a house so she can get out?